Rechargeable batteries last way longer if you do not charge them up to 100% or fully discharge them. This is particularly important for batteries in expensive devices like smartphones or tablets, because repairing a defective battery is expensive. It took Apple many years till, finally, the iPhone 15 can automatically stop charging at 80% and so extend the lifetime of your battery considerably. Maybe Android phones were faster. This is the best solution, but today we will solve the problem for all other devices, including our dashboard tablet in the kitchen. As a bonus, I will show you why we have this tablet and what it displays. And I will reveal the secret behind this number. Gritzy YouTubers, here is the guy with the Swiss accent, with a new episode and fresh ideas around sensors and microcontrollers. Remember, if you subscribe, you will always sit in the first row. This video will be short because we can integrate many things we already have. We will use different ESP Home smart switches to switch USB power on and off. We will find a way to read the battery level of our smartphones and tablets and transfer it to Home Assistant. We will use a simple Home Assistant automation to monitor and act accordingly. And I will reveal the secret behind this weight display coming from a connected Bluetooth scale in the bathroom. Maybe an idea for your New Year's resolutions? It all started when I placed a tablet running fully kiosk on our coffee maker. Because it was cheap and good enough, I purchased an Amazon Fire tablet and connected it to a charger. From then on, the tablet was always charged to 100%. This is absolutely not needed and will shorten the life of the battery considerably. You might think that this does not matter because even with a defective battery, my tablet will work. You are right, unless the battery does blow up or short-circuit itself. I did not want this risk and decided to solve the problem. Switching USB power on and off is a piece of cake for us. We either use a mains smart switch, like a Sonoff laying around in our bin, or use such a USB switch shown in video number 317. Both can be tasmatized or, as I do because I use Home Assistant, flashed with ESP Home. Like that, we have no need for a cloud, and they are snugly integrated into Home Assistant. These USB switches go up to 20 volt, by the way, so you are protected against modern charging standards. As another battery protection measure, I avoid fast charging, so I did not test if they work. This might be different for your smartphone, where you sometimes want to be sure to get a fast charge. If so, you must use a switchable plug to switch the charger on and off. Then your smartphone should charge fast, if you are lucky. If you want to know more about the difficulties of modern chargers, cables and broken promises, you have to wait till the new year when I will create a video on all you have to know about USB-C and why your phone sometimes does not charge fast or does not transfer files at the expected speed, even if the leaflet promised all the bells and whistles. So stay tuned. Anyway, the first problem is solved, and we can remotely switch the USB power of our tablet on and off. Cool. The next problem is more difficult. How to read the actual battery level using Home Assistant? Here I found two methods, and maybe you know others. I start with a tablet where I installed Fully Kiosk for our dashboard, because it is simple to use and hard to kill. Two properties particularly important for family life, if you know what I mean. This software has an integration into Home Assistant that exposes many sensors and some switches. The one of interest is called battery level changes. So we only need a bit of glue, called automation, to connect the sensor with the switch. Here you see my two simple triggers. If the battery level is above 80%, the charger is switched off, and if it is below 20%, charging starts. You can set these values to 49 and 51% if you want to keep the battery level fixed. And you could add a monthly automation to charge the battery to 100% to calibrate the battery sensor. But how can we get the battery level from a smartphone where we do not run fully kiosk? Here, we can use the Home Assistant companion app, which also delivers the battery level. So we can create a second automation with a different sensor and a different switch. Problem solved. But what if my wife wants to use the same charger for her smartphone? Not so good. The chance that her phone is uncharged in the morning is high if mine did not need a charge. We use separate chargers, so no problem. If not, it could be an application for an NFC tag where the phone reads a tag glued to where the phones are charged. Then the smartphone reads the NFC tag and Home Assistant should know which one is charged. You could even set different maximum charging levels. So far, I have not used NFCs other than the one injected in our cat. But I feel that this is stuff for another video. For the smartphone, of course, the automation is easier. Because we always want to charge to 80%, we only have to have one rule. You see how you can easily extend the battery life of your expensive smartphones and tablets by integrating what we already know or even have in our homes. And for the guys who tell me that they will never leave home with an 80% charged phone, I say that I never leave home without a small power bank unless I go with my car or my e-bike, because without my smartphone, I'm pretty much lost these days. The car and the e-bike have USB chargers, by the way. So starting with an 80% charge is no problem for me because I can give it a quick charge if really needed. But why do I want a tablet in our kitchen? You do not see any switches on the display because I'm no big fan of replacing mechanical switches with switches far away from where they are used. So, what is the purpose of our tablet? First, it shows the performance of the solar plant in relation to the consumption and the battery level. Everybody with a solar plant knows that this is a must. Next, a sign. You can start a washer lights up when there is a surplus of 2.5 kW from the solar panels. Washers are our biggest consumers that can be shifted in time. Cooking, the other heavy consumer, usually is not so flexible, at least if I'm hungry. A forecast that shows you if tomorrow you will get more solar power helps you shifting the washing one day. Then we get the outside temperature. This is important because we often use our bikes and we want to know how to dress. The wind gust display is for me. Because I own some antennas here and there, I want to know if it gets dangerous for them. And then is my weight, but more later. One level below, we have signs for green, paper and cardboard. These things are collected by community service according to a schedule I included in Node-RED. So I know when I have to bring the stuff to the agreed place. You heard right, I did not say we. And we have the You've Got Mail, one of the highlights of my day. It is provided by the two LoRa sensors of my mailbox. So it disappears if I fetched the mail. And no, here I do not complain. The next panel shows the detailed performance of the solar plant for a day. And the third shows the weather for the last week. Aggregated rain levels can be important in deciding when to water the plants, for example. This is still a manual task in our family. But why is my weight shown on the screen? This is a strategic topic. I decided that I do not want to get fat. And I get fat without proper measures. This is why I have a deal with my wife. Each Friday, my weight has to be below a certain level. Otherwise, I have to pay her 100 Swiss francs. She can do whatever she wants with this money, and I cannot order gadgets for the next time. But why is it a strategic option? because I proposed this system to keep me disciplined, not her. If she would have proposed it, it would be a simple punishment. Do you see the difference? And no, no need to propose that you will do the job for less money. This was already proposed by all her friends. But unfortunately, this strategy does not work if it does not hurt. I told you this story because it is close to the new year when we often set goals. One secret stays. How often have I already had to put the money on the kitchen table? With this secret in mind, I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. That was all for today. As always, you find all the relevant links in the description. I hope this video was useful or at least interesting for you. If true, please consider supporting the channel to secure its future existence. Thank you. Bye.